Hello everybody, in this video I'm going to show you my three favorite variable ND filters that I use regularly and always recommend. These are the PolarPro Peter McKinnon Edition variable ND filters, the Moment variable ND filters, and the Freewell variable ND filters. Now one of these stands out as the best of the best I've used so far. And another one stands out as the best value for money I've found so far. Now, if you want to find out which is which, and also learn all the ins and outs of how these filters work and why they're so useful, stick around and watch this video. All of these come split into sets of two filters. One has a range of 2 to 5 stops, and the other has a range of 6 to 9 stops. I use these three sets of filters for my iPhone videography, and more recently with the Fujifilm mirrorless cameras too. They perform the best out of all the different filters I've tried, and I believe represent the best at different price points. The PolarPro Peter McKinnon Edition variable NDs are the most expensive, at $250 each for these 67mm filters. Now they are selling the second edition of these filters. I have the first edition. Optically, these are the best I've used, and they have the most neutral color overall. They do introduce a slight color shift, but it's easily corrected. The Moment variable ND filters are also excellent, and only $150 each or $280 for the pair. Smaller sizes are a bit less expensive. Like all of these filters, they do introduce a color shift, and a little bit more than the PolarPro filters, but also easily corrected. Finally, the Freewell variable ND filters are the best value for money I've found so far. The 67mm size like this are only $110 each, or $220 for the pair. So they're not currently offering a discount when you buy them both, at least not at the time of this video, but they are the best value nonetheless. Now as a color nerd, I've found no issues using any of these three sets of filters. The PolarPro filters require the least correction, the Moment and Freewell filters about the same. Now you may have heard this analogy before. An ND filter is like sunglasses for your camera. It cuts out a certain percentage of light by either reflecting it or absorbing it and letting the rest pass through. This allows you to either open up your lens aperture or lower your shutter speed while maintaining the same exposure. The ratio of light the filter transmits is the strength of the ND filter, and it's measured in stops. A one-stop ND filter would reduce the light by half, or 50%. A two-stop ND filter would reduce it by half again, so 75% in total. Every additional stop reduction reduces the light by another 50%. If you use an ND filter to reduce light by one stop, for example, or 50%, you can then either open up your lens aperture by one stop, this lets twice as much light in to make up for it, or you can half your shutter speed, which is to let the light hit your sensor for twice as long, and maintain the same overall exposure level. Now with a smartphone camera, we can't change the lens aperture. I know there have been a couple of oddballs with a variable aperture, but for the most part, the lens aperture is fixed. Using an ND filter simply allows us to shoot with a slower shutter speed in bright conditions. The reason we do this is to record a more pleasing motion blur, instead of jittery, ultra-sharp movement at a shutter speed in the thousandths of a second. Sadly, not all ND filters are created equally when it comes to reducing the spectrum of visible and some invisible light evenly. Generally, you get what you pay for. What we see as white light is made up of the full spectrum of visible wavelengths. The composition of that mix also determines whether that white light appears warmer or cooler in color temperature. A perfect neutral density filter will reduce every wavelength of light by the same ratio, as well as some invisible wavelengths at the infrared and ultraviolet end of the spectrum that many camera sensors are also sensitive to. Unfortunately, this is where the differences in many ND filters show up. When light in one part of the spectrum is transmitted more or less than others, you get color shifts in the image. There are no perfect ND filters. Now, there are some fixed density ND filters which come close, but variable ND filters always involve some compromises. A variable ND filter differs from a fixed density ND filter. where a fixed density ND filter relies on precise coatings to reflect or absorb a certain percentage of light, a variable ND filter relies on an entirely different principle. Variable ND filters rely on the polarization of light. A single polarizing filter selectively allows light to pass that is oriented in one particular direction. When two polarizing filters are stacked together and one is rotated against the other, it becomes possible to block a certain percentage of light from passing through entirely. And the angle of rotation determines the amount of light that can pass. This is a variable ND filter. One of the unfortunate effects of just about all ND filters, but especially variable ND filters, is that color shifts can be introduced. Now, this can be a general shift warmer or cooler, but it can also affect how specific colors are recorded. The solution is either to white balance through the filter using a gray card, or my approach has been to build color corrections for each filter that I use in post-production. I do this because I want to record a consistent color balance by using a fixed white balance preset in camera. This makes color correction and grading much faster, more accurate, and consistent. Now I'm going to make my corrections for these three specific variable ND filters available for purchase on my website soon, and make a video tutorial showing you how to apply these in DaVinci Resolve. So if you aren't subscribed yet and you want to catch those, now's a good time to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification button. Now, if you're shopping for variable ND filters, you'll see a lot of variable ND filters that promise a wide range of density in a single filter. Now, this may seem like a good way to spend less and get more, but just be aware that the strongest few stops of those filters are usually useless. Now, if you're shooting outside in bright sunlight, it's the stops at the strongest end of that range that you're going to want to use most. The reason they're unusable is that at an extreme difference in polarization angle between the two stacked polarization filters, and this is when most of the light is blocked or it's at its strongest, an unwanted effect can be introduced called cross-polarization. Now, the solution to this is to never let those two stacked polarizing filters ever get to that extreme angle relative to each other in the first place. And this means limiting the overall range of density of each ND filter, which is why these three, my favorite sets, and others as well, are split into two separate filters. It's not just a tactic to get more money out of you or to sell you two filters instead of one. There's a scientific reason behind it, and the optical performance shows this. The most common split is one filter providing 2 to 5 stops reduction, and the other filter providing 6 to 9 stops. Now, if you can only afford to get one filter and not two, you need to ask yourself, what conditions do you most often shoot in? If you shoot outside in bright sunlight, a 6 to 9 stop variable ND filter is going to be the most useful to you. But if you shoot in overcast conditions, cloudy conditions, or maybe interiors, the 2 to 5 stop ND filter might suit you better. Ideally though, you'll want both to be covered. A good variable ND filter, or a fixed density ND filter for that matter, are universal in function. And this is why I choose to use common, round, threaded photographic filters rather than a proprietary filter system made just for smartphones. Now, there are many ways to mount common, round, threaded photographic filters on your smartphone. Now, if you're attaching lenses, you'll want to make sure you have the filter mount made for your lenses. Here are a few examples, such as the Moment, B-Script, Moondog Labs, and Ulanzi. If you're not attaching lenses, you can also find filter mounts with common smartphone lens mounts that attach directly to a case or a cage. This one is for the threaded Ulanzi mount, for example. And this one is for B-Script. My favorite is the Moondog Labs multi-camera filter mount, which is very lightweight and works very well with a lightweight Moment case. When it comes to sizes of filters, I try to buy filters that are large enough to cover all the lenses I want to use them with. Now for you, this might even include DSLR lenses or mirrorless camera lenses as well. My filters are all 67mm in diameter, and I use different step-up rings to adapt them to different filter mounts. Taking all of these factors into consideration, these are my three favorite pairs of variable ND filters. Now the PolarPro are the best, but they're also the most expensive. The Freewell variable ND filters are the ones I recommend the most. They're the best value for money. And the Moment ND filters are somewhere in between, but closer to the Freewell filters in performance than the PolarPro. You can find links to all three of these filter sets in the video description. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and feel free to ask any questions in the video comments, and I'll see you in the next one.